Assalamualaikum and a very good morning to all my students of 10th standard. So today we are going to do the third video on the lesson Footprints Without Feet. Children, we have already done two videos in which we have seen Griffin, who is a scientist and who has discovered a rare drug, how his life changes after he tries that drug on himself. What are the different things that he does after taking the rare drug? What are the misuses that he do? Okay, so let us see, after burning the house of the landlord, after taking advantage in the big store in London, after stealing away the wardrobe from a theatrical company shop, how he runs away and how people are after him, okay, for chasing him. Thereafter, let us see what happens. See, you can see in the picture, people are running after him. Okay, so here we are. Eager to get away from crowded London, he took a train to the village of Iping, where he booked two rooms at the local inn. The arrival of a stranger at an inn in winter was in any case an unusual event. A stranger of such uncommon appearance sent all tongues wagging. Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife, made every effort to be friendly, but Griffin had no desire to talk and told her, "My reason for coming to Iping is a desire for solitude. I do not wish to be disturbed in my work. Besides, an accident has affected my face." So, in order to escape from the huge crowd that was running after Griffin so as to chase him, because he had stolen and he had stolen the clothes as well as robbed the money from the shopkeeper. So what he has done here, he started running. Now while he was running, children, he was running away, the best way to save himself from the crowd was to catch a train. So he, because he had already removed all of his clothes, so he has become invisible, right? So when he had already become invisible, in that situation, he can easily board the train without any tickets. And that train took him to Iping. So he has reached a village named Iping. Now when he had reached there, now villages are generally small, villages are small in size. So if anything happens in one corner of the village, it's known by everybody in the village. So here it is. He has eager to get away from crowded London, right? So now he wanted to go away from the crowded city like London. He took a train to the village of Iping. So he reached here, Iping, where he booked two rooms at a local inn. What is inn? It is a hotel, right? Where you can stay and have food as well, right? So he had booked two rooms in a local motel. The arrival of a stranger at an inn in winter. Now probably winter is not the right time when visitors come to this village. So when in such awkward situation, in awkward circumstances, any visitor came to the village, now everybody's tongue started wagging. That means everybody started talking about the new visitor. So a stranger of such uncommon appearance. Now the stranger was with very uncommon appearance. Now children, why uncommon appearance? Because you remember, he had removed his clothes while running from the big store of London, right? Then after he reached to the Drury Lane and he entered a shop wherein he tied his face with bandages and then he wore a false nose. Usne ek nakli naak bhi lagayi, fir usne whiskers bhi lagaye and he took a wardrobe. Then he started running. Now when he was running, he was, you know, there was such a big crowd after him chasing him, so he thought better to take a train and reach to a village. So he reached to Iping. Now when he reached here, the first thing was, this was a very uncommon time for visitors to come in this village, okay? So in winter, no visitors used to come in I think at this season. So first thing, this was very uncommon. Second thing, that our griffin had wore bandages, and then over that he has worn the dress and the false nose and everything. So that was not looking realistic. वो अजीब लग रहा था, वो सच नहीं लग रहा था, right? So people were talking about him. Mrs. Hall. Now name of the landlord's wife was Mrs. Hall. Mr. and Mrs. Hall. So Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife, made every effort to be friendly. Now Mrs. Lord tried to talk much with Griffin, but Griffin said that he had come there for solitude. Solitude means to stay all alone without any disturbance. He says that he had undergone an accident, right? He had met an accident which has affected his face badly. Now, because his face is damaged, so, you know, he want to convey here that because his face is damaged, that is why he has been wearing the bandages over his face. So, he said that he had met an accident recently, because of which his face was damaged, and thus he is looking to be all alone. So, he don't want to mingle with anybody, nor he wants anybody to disturb him, okay? Satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist. Okay. Satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist, and in view of the fact that he had paid her in advance, Mrs. Hall was prepared to excuse his strange habits and irritable temper. Now see, children, satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist, and in view of the fact that he had paid her in advance, Mrs. Hall was prepared to excuse his strange habits and irritable temper. Now Mrs. Hall, because she was very friendly in nature, she wanted to talk with him, to know about him, where does he come from and things like that. But Griffin was not in a mood to tell anything to anybody, not only Mrs. Hall, but to anybody. So she thought that person who has come on rent, right? The person who has been in the inn had already paid the amount. So first thing was money. So she, because when the money is paid in advance, she did not bother, right? Second thing, she knew that he was a scientist, and he was eccentric scientist. That means a person, a scientist who is involved in his own work, right? He does not think about or talks about any other people, right? He is always engaged in his own world. So that is why she was ready to say, excuse the strange habits like not talking with anybody, always in being inside the room, and irritable temper. Griffin, definitely he had a very irritable temper. Anybody can get angry with her, with his anger. But the stolen money did not last long, and presently Griffin had to admit that he had no more ready cash. So with stolen money, the money that he had stolen from the shop in Drury Lane. Now that money, it could not last long. Wo zyada nahi chali, because he had to pay the amount at the hotel as well to Mrs. Hall. He had expenses like eating expenses and all. Alright, children. So now he was in need of money, but he did not have any cash. Uske paas ab paisa nahi bacha tha. He pretended, however, that he was expecting a check to arrive at any moment. So he pretended. Usne aisa zahir kiya jaise uska koi check aane wala hai. Kuch dinon mein uska koi check aane wala hai, and then he would be paying the money to Mrs. Fox. Shortly afterwards, a curious episode occurred. A very strange thing happened in a short time. Very early in the morning, a clergyman and his wife were awakened by noises in the study. So what happened in a very short time period? What happened here was, children, clergyman, first of all, understand what is a clergyman. Clergyman is a main member of a church. Okay, so one of the member, clergyman, in his house, what has happened? They were awakened. That means the husband and wife, the clergy and his wife, must be sleeping, but they were awakened. Wo jag gaye. Why did they woke up? By noises in the study. So they must have heard some noises in the study room. creep down, that means they very slowly came down, right? And when they came near the study room, they heard the chink of money. Sikko ki awaaz unhe khatkhanahat sunai de rahi. That was taken away from the clergyman's desk. So somebody was taking money from the clergyman's desk without making any noise, and with a poker grasped firmly in his hand, the clergyman flung open the door. Surrender. So now when they heard the sound of money, that means the desk being opened and the money being taken, they heard the sound completely. Now they were sure that there is somebody inside who is stealing the money. So what did they do? They took a poker so as to attack the thief, right? So when they went inside, clergyman flung open the door. So clergyman pushed the door and immediately went inside and said, surrender. Okay. Then to his amazement, he realized that the room appeared to be empty. But when he went inside, did he find anybody? No. Did he see anybody? No. There was nobody and the room was empty. He and his wife looked under the desk. So, and behind the curtains and even up the chimney, there wasn't a sign of anybody. So they searched in the whole room, but there was nobody in the room. Yet the desk was had been opened and the housekeeping money was missing. They searched for the person, the thief, everywhere, but they could not find anybody. But yes, stealing had been done because the desk was opened and the money which was kept for housekeeping, that money had been stolen. Extraordinary affair, the clergyman kept saying for the rest of the day. So here clergyman was really surprised because the theft has been done, but nobody was seen inside the room. So he what tag he gave to the event, he said extraordinary affair. Ye bilkul bhi unholy baat hai, that chori hui hai par wahan koi hai nahi. Definitely he must be thinking that there is some ghost. But it was not as extraordinary as the behavior of Mrs. Hall's furniture a little later that morning. So in the same morning, right, early morning, this happened at the clergyman's house. Then later, same morning, the landlord and his wife were up very early. So Mr. and Mrs. Hall, they woke up very early and were surprised to see the scientist's door wide open. So they generally, Griffin used to shut the door, keep his door shut. But they were shocked to see that the doors were wide open. Puri tarike se khule hue the. Usually it was shut and locked, and he was curious if anyone entered his room. So Griffin used to get angry when somebody enters the room without his permission, right? So what has happened here? That is why Mr. and Mrs. Hawks were shocked, because the rooms were wide open. Generally he used to shut the door and lock them. The opportunity seems too good to be missed. So that was the best chance. Griffin was not there and his house, his room was open. They peeped around the door, saw nobody and decided to investigate. So they peeped. Peeping is jhankana. So they peeped through the door. Why did they peep? To see whether Griffin was there or not. But they did not find anybody. Unhe andar koi dikhai nahi. The bedclothes were cold, showing that the scientist must have been up for some time. And stranger still, the clothes and bandages that he always wore were lying about the room. So the bandages that he used to tie were still lying on the bed. So they found nobody, but these things were there on his bed. All of a sudden, Mrs. Hall heard a sniff close to her ear. Now when Mr. and Mrs. Hall, they went inside the room, there was nobody. But all of a sudden, Mrs. Hall, she heard some sniff. Kuch soonghne ki awaaz uske kaan ke paas aane lagi. But there was nobody. A moment later, the hat on the bedpost leapt up and dashed itself into her face. And what happened? Even just the very next moment, Then the bedroom chair became alive. That means the bedroom chair, it started moving by itself, springing into the air. It charged straight at her legs foremost. So all of a sudden, the chair, it started moving all of a sudden by itself, and it hit into the Mrs. Hall's legs. As she and her husband turned away in terror, now they were terrorized. So काफी घबरा गए थे because all the things were, you know, into the air by itself. Definitely, any common man would be surprised, shocked. So they were into terror, and the extraordinary chair pushed them both out of the room, and then appeared to slam and lock the door after them. So the chair which came near their leg, they pushed both the husband and the wife out of the room. And then the moment they were out of the room, the door was locked from inside. I hope you will read this at home and try to understand it. And definitely I am going to conduct my next video, inshallah, tomorrow. Till then, take care of your health. Have a great day ahead. Good day.